Hi there, I'm Andy Yates, I'm the Ensembl Support Coordinator, I'm one of the developers of the Ensembl API. Today I'm going to show you how to install the Ensembl API on your computer. All the commands used in this tutorial are available at this URL, if you want to copy and paste them. You can also browse our website's online documentation at www.ensembl.org/info/docs/API. The guide also assumes that you're using Linux or MacOSX. Windows users should look for more instructions from our website. You need to have Perl installed in order to use the API. Let's make sure we have it before starting the installation. We're going to type the command Perl -v. As you can see here, we've got Perl 5 installed, version 14, subversion 2, more commonly known as Perl 5.14.2. That's perfect for Ensembl. You'll also need DBI and DBD MySQL installed to allow Perl to work with our MySQL databases. Please follow your operating system's instructions on how to install these dependencies. Let's create a directory for the Ensembl API modules we're about to install. So we're going to make sure we're in our home directory. Now we're going to make a directory called source and change it into it using the cd command. As you can see, there is nothing in this directory. First, we need to download BioPerl. As of the recording of this video, Ensembl requires BioPerl 1.2.3. So let's download it from GitHub using the command wget, unzip it, and then rename the directory. You'll need to download BioPerl from the following URL. BioPerl is quite a hefty distribution, so this will take a reasonable amount of time. Great, we've managed to download BioPerl. We're just going to do a quick directory listing to confirm that it's there. Now we'll unzip. Another quick directory listing. And now we're going to rename the BioPerl directory to the directory name BioPerl-1.2.3. Final directory listing confirms that BioPerl is there and ready to go. If you have Git installed, you can use it to download the Ensembl packages you need. If you do not have Git, you can skip this section. To test if you have Git, we're going to try to execute the command and ask for its version. We do this by typing in git dash dash version. The double dash here is very important. As you can see, we have Git version 1.7.9.5, which is perfect for installing Ensembl. We're now going to run 5 clones, one per Ensembl project and one for the Ensembl tools. You want to clone Ensembl from the following URL. Type it into your command terminal and press return. These projects are very large, so they will take some time to download. Great, we have Ensembl. Now we can repeat the process once for variation. We can also repeat it for comparer. We can also repeat it for funcgen. And finally, tools. A quick directory listing shows that we have the Ensembl, Ensembl Comparer, Ensembl Funcgen, Ensembl Variation, and Ensembl Tools projects downloaded. Whenever you clone Ensembl projects, we'll always check you out onto the latest stable release. We do offer an alternative system called the Ensembl git-tools project. This automates the cloning process and many other common processes you may want to perform on our repositories. These commands are available from GitHub at https://github.com/ensembl/ensembl-git-tools. If you don't have Git installed, you can always download the API from our FTP site. is available as a tarball and contains all the required APIs to run Ensembl. The file is quite large and it will take a significant amount of time to download. To download, we'll use the wget command and go to ftp.ensembl.org/pub/ensembl-api.tar.gz and press return. This is now downloading it. You can see that the tarball is currently 68 megabytes. This tarball is updated nightly for the current Ensembl release, so you can always be assured of getting the latest code whenever you download from this tarball. Now that it's finished, we need to decompress the API into the local directory. To do so, we'll use the tar command and the command line flags zxf. Z means decompression, x means extract, and f allows us to specify the tarball we want to act upon. We press return, and in a few moments we will have a selection of directories decompressed onto our file system. If we use the ls command, you can see that the directories are now available. Now we've downloaded all the Ensembl Perl modules, we need to tell the Perl interpreter where to find them. To do so, we need to add these modules onto the Perl 5 environment variable. How we do so depends on your current shell. To check your shell, type in echo $shell in all capital letters and press return. As you can see here, my shell is currently bash. To add the Ensembl modules onto my Perl 5 lib in bash, I'm going to use the nano text editor, and I am also going to edit the .profile file in my home directory. As you can see here, there are a number of lines exporting the Ensembl modules and the BioPerl modules onto my Perl 5 lib. These will not be in your .profile, and you should copy and paste them from the accompanying material with this video. Once copied and pasted in, press Ctrl O and return to write the file to disk, and Ctrl X to exit out of Nano. If you are a C shell user, you should edit the .chrc file in your home directory. We will use the Nano text editor. And as you can see, there are a number of lines here exporting BioPerl and the Ensembl modules onto your Perl 5 lib. Again, you should copy and paste these lines from the accompanying material with this video. Please also pay attention to the difference in how you actually export environment variables between the two shells. Again, to exit and write the file out of Nano, hold down Ctrl O, return to write the file, and Ctrl X to exit out of Nano. Now we need to source the file we've just edited. Since I'm in bash, I will do this by saying .\/.profile and press return. To check that this has worked, I will echo Perl 5 lib as shown here, and as you can see, the Ensembl modules are now available on my Perl 5 lib. Now Ensembl is available on our Perl 5 lib, we're going to try and ping Ensembl to make sure we can communicate. To do so, we're going to use a script that ships with Ensembl called ping Ensembl. To access this script, we will cd into the Ensembl directory and then into the misc scripts directory. We'll then type in /ping_ensembl.pl and press return. If there are any problems during the installation of the API, the ping Ensembl script will tell you of those problems. As you can see, success means that you get the following message saying installation is good, connection to Ensembl works, and you can query the human core database. Well, thanks very much for watching. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them at the email address shown below.